Well, it has been some time, ladies and gentlemen. We're finally back with a match in the Mountain Thrill Challenge. This is the loser bracket round 2. With Vega Squadron versus Hey United in this best of 3 series. With me is from Rasmus TV, the Maker. Man, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Thank you for having me. It was a pleasure to come on.
And we haven't casted in some time. I believe last time we casted was with the SEA Cups, right?
Yes, we casted the Inside Dota 2 Asia Challenge, I think it was the name of the tournament, but it was a long time ago.
I was like too long.
Yeah, I don't even want to go there. I'm an old man. But good to be back with some European Dota, because you know the Southeast Asia times, I think we can both agree on, are not, you know, suited for the European casters. So
no, we were not following the scene closely enough for that.
No, we don't. You know, we don't know the teams that well. The players are kind of sketchy, and good to be back with Vega and her.
Yeah, man, it's a good starter to be with me again, I guess.
it's always nice to cast with you. Like, there's always something interesting we can talk about or say about the games. Hopefully,
you know, it really depends on always,
Edward's all over the place.
Oh man, but yeah, man, what do you think? Vega gonna win this one, or are they gonna lose again versus Hey? Since last time they played with us, they actually lost. So,
yeah, I wasn't sure whether or not Vega was actually gonna win this. But if you look at the bets on eBattle, as we mentioned before the game actually started, it was an 80% win rate going towards Vega. So, if we look by that, it should be an easy win. And I want to say Vega probably has the
honestly
stronger. But you know, with after the TI qualifiers, it seems like every team is just
taking a step back.
Yeah, I don't know. It just seems so disorganized. You know, teams that were normally, you know, we had the first game TV Cup here yesterday, and it was running all week, and we saw Dusa just, you know, rolling over everybody, and Scary Faces losing games, Four Anchors losing games. It was just, you know, we're like, okay, where are our predictions going? Because this is just 5 seconds going every which way.
I think that might have a little bit to do with, like, you just didn't make it into the open qualifier or into the main event, and you're a little bit disorganized, a little bit like, what do we do now? We wanted to be there, and a little bit motivation, maybe. You have to start getting up again and go for TI6, but it's early for that, maybe, to get their head into the game for that.
Yeah,
it's understandable. You just want to go to TI.
Exactly. That's like the peak of the year, I guess, for most professional players is can I get to TI? And if I can, you know, it's a good thing. Disruptor, Gyro, Tiny Earthshaker, and as we said, it's gonna be a Lash ban, dude. It's gonna be a Lash ban.
and a quap. And the respect ban for Mac.
Yeah.
Beastmaster.
That's actually true.
I actually really like that hero. It's really fun to play with. Like, if people don't respect it enough, you just completely dominate the lane.
Yeah. 5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, it's definitely a respect ban here.
It's gonna be Tusk coming out for Vega, and yet no Wisp has been banned yet. I just wanna.
I think quickly throw that out there.
It's still in the pool if they wanna go for it. And with Tiny on Hehe, I don't. They could go for the Wisp, or they could just be baiting them to go for the Wisp, but it's still in the pool, so, you know, it's still.
But you're playing versus a Gyro and Disruptor.
Yeah, it's definitely a hard matchup, you know, with the AoE being there, and Gyro gonna rip through your. Hero was pretty easy. She is not the most tanky hero, so yeah, we'll have to see.
Although it's strength, yes, like zero HP. Like,
yeah.
Right out. Make it intelligent, man. Nice.
It's a ball of love, but it doesn't fare well against a Gyro. It's gonna be a Lina pickup for him. That's okay. Wow. We didn't actually see any Lina in our tournament, unfortunately.
They just want to blow up people. Versus a Gyrocopter, you need it. Like, if you just get something to blow him up in the, especially in the mid game, it's great. Just before the BKB.
Awesome. Yeah.
And with Tiny there as well, you can actually blow him up quite effectively. But honestly, it's Hehe, so I'm not sure if Tiny is going to be support with them or not, or even offline. I don't know.
Earthshaker's probably going to be roaming, right? Or is he going to be an offlane Earthshaker, maybe?
It could be a roaming duo even with Earthshaker and Lina.
Yeah, that is also a possibility, and I want to say Earthshaker. He's one of the unsung heroes of this patch. He's been picked up a lot, and he's done, I think, pretty well. Consider like he's, I think he's one of the most solid pickups. If you don't know what to get, you just get the Earthshaker because you can always pair something up with him,
Yeah, and
pretty easily.
there's like the defensive capabilities to keep your heroes alive, as well as with the long range fisher, you can always initiate a fight in the beginning of the games. So it's a little bit all rounder, and yeah, I think that's also really why people like it. The
But right now,
dice.
Vega Squadron, who do you think right now is it, do you think Vega has a,
So far in this draft,
yeah,
Vega.
Vega? Okay.
Just because you know you have a Tusk and a Darkseer, I want to see those double Iron Shell into snowball thingies.
Yeah.
Like that's just complete so nasty in the early game. Like you're just forced to get BKBs now. And like
Yes.
ASAP. I'm just looking forward for that, quite honest. And I'm actually wondering what Hay is thinking that right now, because they really like the Darkseer themselves.
Yeah,
Just
it's a pick we've seen up. It's kind of an underused pick, I think. A lot of teams use it though, if they can, if they can get away with it, if they get team fight
Wind
oriented
Ranger
heroes
at
like
your
Gyro
service.
Disruptor. It's gonna be a Wind Ranger, so
God, dude,
Wind
I need someone
Ranger
now.
offlane, mid, or Lina mid. Could, or, as you said, the support duo of Urshic or Lina could be a possibility, but there's a lot of, that's the good thing about these generic lanes. You
But
don't know where they're actually
it
gonna
doesn't
go,
fare well.
They could run every which lane they wanna go,
Seconds remaining.
Yeah, it's they can just go anywhere, and that's just the strength of these heroes. But the problem is like,
Reserve time.
how are you actually gonna run it? Because that's something that you could also start asking yourself as a team. Like,
The
okay,
green
now we have these
team's
picks.
banning someone
What are we gonna
now.
do with them?
Yeah, where do we put this tiny, or what do we do with the Earthshaker? I want to say, just because you picked Vega, I'm just gonna go with Hehe. I'm just gonna, flat out
You're gonna go
disagree.
against me because
Exactly, yes.
you don't want to
Something I
be.
always do with the, my Coke or my, yeah,
5 seconds
the other
remaining.
guy I'm casting with.
Yeah, whatever.
Whether or not he's right, I don't care. I'm just going,
You just want to go against him.
exactly.
Reserve
It's
time.
a principle thing. It's not,
You're
it's
just
not
a
about the
rebel.
drafts.
Just a rebel.
Yeah. I'm a hater, man. I'm a hater.
But yeah, one thing I have to say, why the fuck is EO just not manned out?
Yeah, I don't.
Like they have good solutions to deal with it, but still an IO Tiny is still really scary.
Yeah,
Like
and I
you
mean,
might as well do it.
exactly. And with the Lina and the Frey, Tiny Wisp is gonna be a real issue for the side of Vega. Like, even if you get a BKB on Gyro, it's still,
Yeah.
yeah. I'm gonna be interested to see if they actually pick it up. They could be picking up something else, but it's obviously a really strong pickup. So. And the lanes are going to be pretty easy, right? You could put Wind Ranger off lane, Tiny
Mid.
Wisp bottom, and then
Riot Peak.
Urshicker possibly on the bottom as well, or he could roam, and then you got Lina mid, right? So
Can do so much.
yeah.
You can even do the Earthshaker on the offlane. Have Lina mid, Wind Ranger roaming support, and then Io plus Tiny on
Yeah, so
the
it's a lot of possibilities,
same
but Vega, I think we can agree they're probably looking for their mid laner right about now.
Yeah, they're looking for someone for no one.
Yes.
Something. Let's see, they just banned out the DK, one of his go-to heroes in this patch. What do we have left? Shadow Fiend, they took that out themselves.
Five
Lashwreck is
seconds
out.
remaining.
Pop is out.
Maybe EA is nice to help with the
Reserve
refraction
time.
versus the avalanche damage.
Could
As
be.
well with, if you just throw a random Laguna on him, he's actually quite able to block. Okay, they're gonna go for Puck.
Gonna be a puck. Okay.
More control.
Radiant
Some
team
yeah, some
down.
more some more control team fight oriented. I kinda like that. I wanna see a TA again because I love TA, but yeah. Puck probably the safer pickup.
Yeah, I'm just this. All of these heroes are actually really good versus an
The Wisp,
IO.
yeah.
Yeah, like what's it gonna do? A Puck is just too versatile. You can just way with too much mobility to get out. The Darkseer can just also search away. Tusk can just go into Snowball, and it gives him another 3 to 4 seconds for the team to come in. Disruptor sends you back, and Gyrocopter just kills you.
5 seconds
Yeah.
Like in laser stations, but yeah, now you're really like, what's he gonna pick?
Reserve
time.
It's very
This is
tough.
free, you know.
Get the Wisp, man. I just want to see the Wisp.
Yeah,
Five
it's just a fun
seconds
hero.
remaining. Yeah.
It doesn't get through. Are they gonna
It's gonna be a
go?
Nyx.
Okay,
Wow.
it's usually
Okay.
this is like one of the go-to lines, but usually a Tiny is a spear breaker.
Yeah, that's actually true.
There's like a hey thingy, but we're gonna see it. The Coon, that's their off laner, so we have an off lane Tiny. That's good. Okay, HWA, so mid Wind Ranger.
Yeah,
Mind
and then
control is
port.
Lina.
Yeah.
Luke is gonna be support Nyx, so also okay.
Okay, yeah. Yeah.
So Lina's still gonna go mid though.
Yeah, Lina is gonna go mid, and it's gonna be. I'm just wondering, are they gonna try to contest? You know.
They can actually go. Can they go?
Aggressive?
They could go aggressive.
I want to say they could with the.
Yeah.
You know.
They have enough stuns and other things to keep them down.
Yeah. Just to shut down the gyro a bit, I think would be wise, because I think gyro is also one of the carries in this patch, like PL, that are really strong. Not as strong as PL's in the late game, but still, with his rocket barrage being as good as it is, even though it was nerfed, obviously one of the greater heroes. But on this side of the head, we got QP on the Earthshaker. We're going to be seeing...
HWA.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, on the Windranger. Dark definitely is with them.
Oh, there we go. Smoke immediately.
They want to go aggressive.
Yeah. Gonna be Slayer here on the top lane. In a bit of trouble though.
Oh, Seema. Yeah, he's hot. Fissure. Easy Fissure.
Yeah. Done.
Done. And he's just gonna get full down here. Avalanche on top of him as well. Some right clicks. Casual Thunder there in it as well. And this is gonna be a first blood.
Yeah, impressive Shackle. So, yeah, first blood going the way of Hehe United. Really, really good rotation up top. And it is gonna be an aggressive, I think, still.
Yeah, usually when you do a 5-man rotation to the enemy jungle, you're gonna go aggressive.
Yeah.
Still moving around all over the place. HWA, he's just still waiting for someone to walk in. But they wanna go into this again, maybe.
Oh no, this could be disastrous for the side of Vega. It's gonna be Vanscorn taking the stun to the face, and Hook going in for the kill. Posh with the damage, and...
HWA is still there in the back. Fissure is now going on to Pasha. Pasha is taking a lot of damage. And he's getting out another rocket barrage, but it's not going to be enough to kill off anybody so far. And yeah, a couple of cancels there, but Hook is able to get the stun up and into Lightning Strike Array. Well, at the same time, the Disruptor died to
to Windranger. Yeah, he picked him up. He did die off at the end there, but, you know, still fine. They're going to run the offlane Windranger, and UP going to be rotating top there. So, for the time being, it's going to be some dual in action. On both lanes, for the side of Hehe.
Yeah. Well, they're gonna have a defensive try lane on the side of Vega, but we forgot to completely say all the team.
So yeah, we forgot to say the team names and who was playing what now. And
Yeah, we got some people. We got Kwepe.
We got QP, we got HWA, and we got, I wanna say, okay, Hook gonna be playing the Nyx mid, of course. On the bottom, we're gonna have Mind Control as well, and his Lina. And of course, the Kuhn gonna be on that tiny. The bottom lane.
And then on the dire side, we have Vega. And for him, we have start off with Mac here on the darks here. A little bit of aggressive farming onto the lane. We'll take some casual harassments from Mind Control. On the mid lane, we have no one on the Puck. We have Vanscore on the Disruptor. We have Pasha playing the Gyro. And that leaves, of course, Seema the Slayer on the Tusk.
Yes.
So we did our duty.
We're done for today. We can rest easy now.
We're done
Nobody
for today.
Can... Yeah, you didn't introduce the players like a pro caster. Yeah, we forgot. Sorry.
Sorry, guys. Yeah, it's not our problem.
Yeah. And
it kinda is, but who cares?
Yeah, I guess it kinda is our problem. What do you think about this Nyx mid versus the Puck?
Well, honestly, Nyx should be fine. Like, if no one tries to do something, you just Scarpus. Apart from the fact that he doesn't have it, you could just do that and then you're already fine. And for the side of no one, if Hook tries to do something, you should be able to maybe dodge it. It's quite even.
He's annoying, especially because he did get a kill there in that early engage, so got a really quick bottle and he's level 4 almost, whereas Puck is actually climbing the ladder as well pretty well, but with that extra gold, maybe a pause gaming. You see what my name is?
Yeah, Paul's Gaming. I saw it already when you were playing today. Like
exactly. Good times.
Oh.
Oh wow.
Those guys.
Exactly.
I'm just happy they're not throwing, obscene figures on the map. That's something HWA does. I'm trying to keep this like, what is it, PG-13-ish.
Like that, you mean?
Yeah. Along those lines. No one saw that.
Mag on the bottom lane, gonna take a drop here, well, maybe, here we go with the stun and the stomp, well, there we go, Earthshaker picking up a kill.
And now, well, in the meantime, they're gonna go in here, in here on top, they got a nice sandbag there with the glimpse, and they just killed them off there, quite easy.
Yep.
Windrun wasn't able to save them there.
They do pick up the Tusk though, which was kind of nice.
Oh yeah, he died by the tower.
So. Yeah, didn't get the experience, but you know, it's still a good thing to get something done.
But the money is split throughout the entire side of the Radiant.
Yeah.
So I was like, eh.
It's not as good, but I think you're a bit more confident going into that line. Yeah, you did die, okay?
So try it again. Well. So, try it again, you're gonna die again, man.
Exactly. Try diving again, I dare you. a bit of Pulp Fiction references there, and well, it's gonna be Mag. It was Slayer on a mind control.
And no one dies here in the middle. Yeah. Nice fissure, who killed him off? This is just the early aggression there with the fissure, long range, just getting killed.
Yeah.
Bomb bottom, nothing happened, just...
No, nothing happened, they just poked each other a bit and went back to farming. But yeah, as you said, I want to say the Urshic with the fissure is probably one of the most effective long range supports in the game. Because he needs his fissure and that's about it.
Yeah,
you know,
well,
to
now
be effective.
He's found out a little bit, Kuhn is there, he's gonna help him out a little bit. They want to toss him back to the tower, but okay, he sees the danger.
Yeah.
And
was hopping. Yeah.
Oh no. HWA died.
Yeah, he's a bit out of there. He's
a little bit too much forward.
Yeah.
Still, if he can just get his levels from now on, it should be fine. It's a wind range he can do without farm if need be.
Yeah.
But yeah, you kind of want to go maybe the slasher build or, you know, get the crits out with the Aghanims there, but.
Yeah. I mean, for the time being, I think he's going to be content with just, you know, getting a level 4 or 5-ish something on the bottom lane, though. Kuhn losing a lot of health there on the Tiny.
Yeah, they're going to rotate Mind Control in right now.
Yeah, smart plays coming out for Vega, I think. Rotating the Tusk down was a smart move.
Yeah, it's the double Iron into a Snowball combo, man.
Yeah.
Talked about it before, it's just...
Yes, exactly.
The only good thing
I think Vega was a bit scared that they were running something crazy on the top lane. So, you know, they just put Tusk there to see what happened. You know, are they running aggressive try? Do we, you know, do anything up here? And then they just saw, okay, it's a wind ranger. We could just send, you know, what we wanted to do earlier on, you know, with the Snowball and Darkseer and just send him down there to clean up.
Yeah, essentially you just need... The Gyrocopter plus the Disruptor is pretty much enough to keep anybody down. If you try to get in close, you get Rocket Barrage. When you run away, you get pinched back. And they're gonna go for no one again, or at least they will try to. Oh no, Snowball in. They're gonna go on Hook, they're gonna try this. Carapace is there though. He goes into Vendetta, no one taking a lot of damage. Is he gonna zip out? He is, but he's now near the tower and he will die to the tower hits right here.
Yeah, that was. yeah.
Nice try.
Yeah, it was a good try. Underestimating, I think, a bit the damage from Hook in the end. But you know, I thought they had him with that Tusk rotating in, and then they just flipped the coin on him and killed him off.
The level 6 on Nyx, man, it's just the instant for that just to deal the damage is so strong. Yeah. The squishy hero like Buck. Now Kwepe, he's gonna get his level 4. He's an happy Urshaker here, man.
And a happy cow here with the Bane mask. I want to give a shout out to that set. It's so cool. Cosmetics, man. Keeping Dota 2 alive.
Keeping people rich.
Exactly.
I mean, games
rich.
Yeah.
I don't know about you. I've lost a lot of money on cosmetics.
I try to not do it. Like in the beginning, when you just start Dota, you're like, yeah, man, I want to have cosmetics for every hero, and then.
Yeah.
After a thousand messages, you're like, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, I lost anyways, you know, so it's, I just, yeah.
Yeah.
Farm-wise.
So far, it's Pasha, of course, taking the lead here. Pretty much uncontested here.
Yeah.
45 less hits already versus the Kuhn with 33. And 0 denies, actually. That's kind of possible.
Yeah, interesting.
Yeah, same goes for Mac. He has 30 less hits, but 0 denies as well. It's not a denying game today. They just want.
No, they don't. They just want to farm in peace. It's fine. Well, I mean, Pasha, if he's left uncontested,
yeah, they kind of have to contest him.
He's gonna get out of control pretty quickly.
Because the Kuhn now has to opt for attack speed items, because there's no, you know, IO with him. So
yeah,
that will limit his farm, or at least not his farm, but. His item choices a little bit, and it means that he has to take more items to really get online.
Yeah.
Pasha, you know, he's, you know, Gyro is always alone. So.
Yeah, and he's gonna have. I was actually gonna say that Vega could also have picked up the Wisp if they wanted to. I mean, yeah. Not with the Tusk being in the fray, but that was also possible here with Gyro.
It's a nice mix. Like just a deny pick there. Yeah. But then I want to say, yeah, okay, Nyx was picked up less, but do you want to pick it into Nyx and Lina?
That is correct.
It's, and Windranger. Mm. Well, it's just easy shackle.
Yeah. Well, Manskook gonna be pulling, but of course Solo not going into that. I think there was an official mid lane.
Yeah, they're gonna go here in mid lane, but it's just a dream call. But no one isn't really able to follow this one up with HWA being so close to the tower and you know multiple people rotating in.
But yes, Solo of course not attending today. I think they released an official statement. Yeah, we do have Ragebaby 322. We apologize for our fans and etc. etc. You can read all about it on their Twitter account, I think,
Or Facebook.
Yeah. So, of course, shout out to Solo for getting married.
Yeah, good job, man.
Yeah, you did it.
You're one of the probably the only people here.
Top lane, QP taking the drop. Maybe not though. Seema.
Who comes in? But this Glimpseback is not gonna do a lot. Well, they're actually just gonna go after him here. Well, Hook is just trying to damage them here, but he has a Vendetta. He's trying to get them low so he can kill him off, but. He's a little bit scared. He's gonna use it now on Seema, the Vendetta, but he just goes into a snowball and yeah, he's gonna stun him up. HWA is there as well, but he's really low as well, and he's gonna die here in regards of Pesh and no one. He just comes in, cleans house, kills off Hook. 3-for-2 trade.
Yeah, that was.
What? Yeah, bot somebody.
Interesting. I don't know what happened there. I was sure Airsugar was gonna live, but then Puck came up and you know, everybody just died, and Pasha living through that was huge. Got 3-1-2 right now currently on the scoreboard, and as well as the top farm in the game.
Yeah, he's gonna go with a little bit more farming oriented build. He's building up towards a Yasha now already after the HUD.
Yeah.
So no fast BKBs or anything along those lines, just casual farming.
And he's not even gone for the homing missile yet, so he's actually, you know, in really good shape. Even if there is, you know, a team fight.
That's the question, do you need a homing missile versus this lineup?
Exactly, I don't...
And with your own? Oh, on bot here. Exactly. Teema was found, Takoon. Ball dropped on top of him, they're gonna try and stop him there with the illusion, but it's not gonna work out. There's gonna be no one, Dreamcall in, it hits only Takoon. Silence on him as well, Takoon is still alive, he's just gonna wait this one out. Well, Mech is getting harassed out, no one is still trying to be here, he get an LSA into his face. But so far they're not really able to go after it because there's Hook in the backline, killing off Mech on the Darkseer. Now they're gonna try and turn this one around on no one as well. He throws out the illusionary orb. It's a casual glimpse there, not glimpse. Phase shift and silence there as well. LSA is gonna hit. He's just gonna get blown up here with the combination of Avalanche into Tusk. 2-for-1 trade going the way of hey.
Yeah.
Whoa. That got turned around.
Yeah, that got turned around. That was good. That was really good. I think Vega's gonna be quite pleased with that, even though they lost the Darkseer and the Darkseer and the Puck. But Gyro got another kill yet, and he's got a Dami now as well. As you said, the Yasha also gonna be completed on him pretty soon. Gonna be setting back the Puck a bit. He was pretty close to his Blink Dagger. He was roughly 700 away, but he's gonna be forced to probably, you know, it's gonna be roughly a 14 to 15 minute Blink Dagger if this continues, you know. So, yeah, all in all, I think Vega's okay with it. It's not the best trade because, you know, losing two of your core heroes to the Tiny as well. Yeah, exactly. It's
not what you want.
No.
It's good to actually say they have a really aggressive ward out here for quite some time already on the pillar here on top. It's just to push in the tower here, but so far they don't have the tower yet. They are not even gonna get it because it's gonna be denied here from Kwepe. He's gonna get glimpsed back into the Tusk, into a nice slap into the face. He's even gonna drop the static storm on him as well. He uses his sticks charge, but it's not gonna be enough. Koon, he blinks in. Toss up into the air of Seaman, he's gonna die there. Barsha, flag cannoning, is trying to get everybody out and away, and he will succeed in doing so.
And Tiny going for the Blink Dagger. Kind of like that.
Yeah, you need the utility.
Yeah, he without the Wisp relocate or anything like that, you know, to buff him up, he's got to have some mobility items and working out on, yeah, like right now he's looking at Vorus 02, so he's doing A-okay in terms of killing off people and.
Yeah, you can just keep him farming, but yeah, you still want to go Aghanim's now and maybe even a drum.
I think a drum would be a good, bridge between the Blink into Ags. I think Ags is a bit heavy to start with. And it makes a lot of sense because now they have the Tiny with the Blink, they have Nyx, you know, he's gotten a level 9. Level 9. He's got a Dagon now as well. So, anybody on the side of Vega, maybe besides the, I guess Gyro could survive, but then again, you got Vendetta, Dagon, Stun, and then the Blink in from Tiny. Should be a dead, any hero on Vega.
They will all get blown up. The only way to really survive to it is to dodge it with a Snowball.
Radiant's middle
tower is under attack. But that might just be a little bit too much ask.
Yeah, to dodge a Nyx in Vendetta plus a Tiny with Blink, it's gonna be mid lane.
Well, there you go. That was just a little bit too much, too far forward, and they were just so ready for this. Yeah, I do want to say one thing, with the Dagon already on Nyx, this is kind of a puppish build. He even skipped the Arcane Boost and went straight into the Dagon, I just want to kill people, screw it all.
I think it's okay because they have the Tiny, so he can kind of open up the mid game for him. I mean, he needs to use it, obviously, to get kills.
HWA, Dreamcold, he tried to TP out. Got Dreamcold to stop it, just gets out of Shackle, but will still die here.
And it, 14 minute Blink Dagger onto no one, so...
Yeah, he had it for a minute now.
Yeah, okay, it's a 13 minute one. But I kind of agree with you, rushing the Dagon, you want to get something out of it as quickly as possible. Thing is, wow, Coon man with the dunks on it.
Oh my god,
he's gonna be a sad one going back to well.
I was just happy I was watching him there. Now Seema, he's found us as well. Is he able to get over the Snowball? He will be. He's gonna go to the Coon, and Coon is like, just come to me, baby.
Yep.
Here we go. LSA into the face. He gets up some shards though, keeping the other side of the team out. But he will still die. The Coon, he's fairly tanky, TPing out. Is there a vacuum? Yes, there is. He's gonna die. What? He's running away? He still has enough luck?
Gotta blink out the red in 1 second.
Yes!
He's gonna be okay. 7
no.
charges.
No.
Got a stun as well, but...
Mech, call down. Miss. He's still running. He's still holding strong. It's gonna be... No! Seriously, the wrong way.
Oh, the jukes are real, I guess. Most obvious way to run, but... It worked out. Pick up the disruptor mid as well.
This is just mind games, man. The Coon, he just makes them think he goes the other way. Yeah, Disruptor again, dead. Oh. Damn.
And it was partially due to the Nyx Dagon.
Yeah, the Dagon, man. Oh. I get it, vibe. It feels really puppish.
It does. I mean, I agree with you. But if you can secure the kills on your Nyx, and I'm not sure if he's probably not going to upgrade it. We'll have to see.
I think he's going to buy maybe Arcanes first. Then it's still kind of core and you want it. Because now every time he goes for a kill, he needs to go back to base.
Yeah. Yes, they do have Arcane Boots on... nobody. Nope. I was going to say the Earthshaker, he did pick up the Tranquil, so... going for the high movement speed. He's going to be picking up a Sol Ring as well. So no mana boots yet for the side of Heihe.
They just need to get a little bit more sustain if you want to keep it up.
Yes, yeah, they want to keep going for kills. And...
Yeah, they have mess bubbles everywhere, but no Arcanes or... along the lines, no mechas, which is to be expected, but yeah.
Because who naturally goes for the mech on the side of Heihe?
You could do it on the Nyx. It's possible, but
you could do it on the Nyx, but
you don't want it.
With his zero Arcane Boots right now, he's not gonna have, as you said, the mana for it. Because if he has a Dagon, a mechanism,
then just no Arcanes, even just the bottle and the stick. It's
no. I guess the Windranger or the Lina could pick it up, but Vega just got they just got a Darkseer. It's such an easy hero, It's like you'll just pick up the mech, right? Yeah, sure, of course.
Yeah. It's just if you have those heroes that just always build it, it's just so nice and helps your team out so much. They're looking for some aggression here on both on the side of Vega, but so far only one who's a little bit close is HWA, and he's just farming up the wood.
Yes.
This is five men down at bottom, doing well. They see nothing.
They're just chilling. They're hanging out. I think they're looking for an opening onto Tiny, but he's actually currently on the top lane. What the hell is Tiny? He's here in the mid lane, sorry. Want to secure the tower, I guess. Or gonna push it down.
Yeah, why not? Just force them out. They know that they're here on bot, so... Just go mid, pushing top as well. And Hook knows nobody's there because he already scouted the jungle twice, so. Now they're gonna start TPing. Three people already into the mid. There's gonna be the Dream Call, but just on Kwepe, and he's like, okay, TP out, but no, Glimpse. He's gonna get killed here. Yeah, there we go. That's gonna be a juked Echo Slam there. Pretty good. Holy shit, and oh no. There's gonna be an aggressive snowball in. He's on the other side of the river. That's not where you wanna be. The grass is not so green over there. Hook walks in, gets off a casual Dagon. But yeah, that doesn't really matter because Kuhn is blowing up the Tusk here right now. Wall is down, but he can follow it up with the Vacuum. But they do have the Glimpse. Kuhn, no, no blink for him. Throwing up Laguna Blade. One other person is dead as well. Vega. Yeah, they're gonna get another kill here. At least a 2-for-2 trade so far. Still, heavy commitments from both sides.
Yeah, they threw a lot. Well, no one got done. Yeah, no, it's gonna be HWO taking a drop and no one on the back foot here. Gonna be A-OK though, with the Darks here as well in the frame. But yeah, a lot of commitment for both from both teams. I think Vega got the better trade. Just the fact that they got Tiny was huge. Three. Yeah.
It was 900 gold.
Exactly. It was, you know, even that, just that kill plus the Windranger going back here on the tier 1 tower would have been enough, but they actually got 3 kills and yeah. Nobody of the cores died on the side of Vega. It was Tusk and Disruptor, right, who died in the fight?
Yeah.
I want to say that, yeah.
They're the, essentially the ones that are the only, yeah, the only one dying really for Vega. But is it Tusk so far has died 7 times, but yeah, that's what to expect with the Tusk. He just dies. Snowboy, you're middle of the fray, and then you just usually get blown up. Just forgive it.
Well, look at the network right now. We're having, of course, to no surprise, it's going to be the Gyro for the side of Vega in the top charts, and kind of followed by the Tiny 8.4 in the bank on his net worth. Not too shabby, but if Gyro gets away with this, and his BKB is not that far off, the blink on Tiny is going to amount to, you know, nothing on the side of, you know, taking down the Gyro. So we'll have to see what happens. Tiny not that far away from his scepter, and well, it's going to be a wow, that was a quick unpause. It's nice.
It's nice. But yeah, just to follow it up on the third, we have Nyx Assassin with on Hook, and he actually has 2k gold in the bank, so he's gonna go for a blink.
Yeah, it is gonna be a blink, and yeah,
we're gonna have blink, boys.
Good blink, blink. We could actually potentially see a blink on Windranger. He's got 1.5k in the.
I was also looking at it like there're gonna be more people there. And exactly. Just only person that's still done needed is the Kwepe. I don't think Mind Control will ever be able to get one.
I don't think he's gonna be he's gonna be farm prioritized like that, so it's gonna be a dead Mind Control maybe, or even no one. Take the Fissure to the face, should be okay, yeah.
Yeah, he can just walk out.
Yeah, that was a
the Fissure kind of works.
Kinda missed that up. Yeah.
But that was just because of Blink. Oh, Blink's back. Shards keeps him away from the tower, but they're not gonna follow this one up. They don't want to dive to tier 1 tower here.
No. And, you know, with the Lina being there, Tusk could easily blow up before, you know, taking out the Earthshaker. It's always risky, but they're just going to do a bit of 5-man Dota and take down towers. They don't really care too much about what the side of Hehe does.
Oh, they have the BKB now, they have the mech for some time, so they're fine.
Yeah.
They're still looking for that ward and they commit another sentry to it, but they won't find it. They do get the tower though. So.
Yeah.
Mech running around the side, he's gonna find Mech as well as Mind Control, I mean Kwepe as well as Mind Control. He's gonna get Glimpse back into the Static Storm there, and it's gonna be the first blood drawn in this fight. Looking for more, Kwepe is still in the back lines, he doesn't want to get caught out here.
No.
Just a fast blood there. Fast
kill. We need to be careful though, Pasha. They just continue with the onslaught, that is the Vega 5-man Dota right now, and well, Vanscore? Gonna be going up with no one as well as Mag, so everybody backing off for the mid lane. Gonna be distributing some farm, actually taking the stack from Hehe United, as that's gonna be two stacks going the way of Pasha. Actually pretty devastating. I think they wanted to farm that up with the Tiny Eggs, as he's just received that, and yeah, no such luck, I'm afraid, on the side of Hehe United. Look at the net worth. It's not, you know, it's a really even game in terms of net worth and experience gain.
Yeah, it's just a little bit more kills for Hey, but apart from that, Vegas, both the charts there ahead, but it's not that much in the very marginal.
Well, yeah,
just one fight and everything can be turned around upside down.
Yeah, I think if either side takes a full 5-man wipe, you know, they're gonna probably take Roche and take it from there, and you know, probably control the game for at least 5 to 10 minutes. But we haven't had the full-on team wipe, you know, where one team just, you know, maybe loses support and then just dominates the fight. Yeah. Well, I can actually see Vega being the ones to do it because they have Disruptor, Gyro, as well as, you know, just Puck.
A little bit more team fights.
Yeah.
But now you have an Earthshake and a Tiny, and I think, yeah, Vega just has a little bit bigger crowd control, I want to say. That will help him out, yeah, but one thing I do want to say, like, both of these lineups aren't really that rush-killing lineups that you see a lot these days. You want to kill it, they need this DD. Yeah. And they need it on Pasha.
Here we go. Pasha at the ready with the DD. He's gonna actually pick up the bottle from no one. Or sorry, who was that? Was that his own bottle?
I don't know.
He picked it up from no one and then he replaced it back into no one's inventory. There we go.
Just to fill it up there.
Yeah.
They're actually gonna take it quite fast with the DD.
Yeah, he's got a lot of damage. So, Pasha gonna be picking up the Aegis, I think, and with and that.
They both raised two tier 2s for tier 1s. Hello, for it, so.
I think I know they can contest just because, as we talked about, the team fight for Vega is just a lot stronger. And
especially on the choke points there.
Yeah, exactly. And it's, let's be honest, it's really difficult to initiate as an Earthshaker onto that team. You got Puck, Disruptor, even the Tusk to worry about. If you get caught out, you're, you know.
You can't even initiate because you don't have your Blink Dagger yet. So essentially you do a Fissure into walk in. So you're not the one initiating. Nyx actually, he just buys Dagon too, and he has a Blink, okay. He's not even...
Yeah, he does have a Blink, yeah.
He's not going Arcanes.
No, he doesn't need Arcanes. He just needs, you know, more damage, dude.
He needs more intelligence, and what's the best way to get it? Well, upgrading your Dagon.
Well, look, scouting for a kill. That might be a dead Slayer if
he walks forward.
He opens
up, there we
it's
go.
Be a dead Slayer, definitely.
Yeah, he does have his Glimmer Cape there, or the Glimmer Cape is not from him. It's gonna be from Fanscore used on him. Dimko is on Kwepe. Kwepe, he's still alive here. Hook is also alive. Only who has fought is Seema. Kwepe is now found by Pasha, so he will die. Hook, yeah, he's gonna be left for dead here. The rest of the team got out. 1-for-2 trade, but it at least forces the entirety of Vega back. But they can't pursue the tier 2 here on bot.
Yes. Well, 1100 gold going the way of the side of Vega. Pressing their advantage. Especially with the Aegis being on Jara right now, it's... good for Vega.
I don't even think, to be honest, I didn't mind that I was too scared or cared about that just because... You know, they forced everybody back, so it means that they at least didn't lose a tier 2.
Yeah, exactly.
Still the problem, you know, indeed, is
Kuhn. If they lose Kuhn now, that's gonna be devastating. That's gonna be Kuhn stunning up Slayer. We have Narshard. Yes, we do. Do we have the Cole? Not at the ready yet. 24 seconds to go. It's gonna be Orb onto the face of Kuhn, and he's probably gonna drop with a Warning Rift. It's gonna get whiffed! With the help of Earthshaker Lina, that's a dead Tusk. He's gonna keep chasing for the Tiny, and they do pick up the Tiny, finally no one. He's got Yules and actually now gonna Yules out, should be okay.
Illusionary Orb.
Yeah, that was a close call. He blinks away as Hook jumps it with a stun. They are gonna pick up the tier 2 because of that.
Yeah, and HWR, he has to start running, he's gonna get called out on him, but yeah, he's able to run out here with the Rindrin. Pasha is still able to pick it up. The tower that is.
Yeah.
There's gonna be a smoke here and walk through middle with Kwepe and Hook. Oh, they find Mac. There we go. Stun into him. Vendetta? No, they don't want to use Vendetta. They just want to kill him. Yeah. Fanscore comes in. Glimpse back. Kwepe, he is stuck here between the Fissure and the kinetic field, but he can just walk out.
Yeah, should be fine. Want to say, though, that Pasha has yet to use his 10-second BKB, so... I guess it's good because they have been winning the fights rather convincingly. They're getting back to the, you know... being tied with for kills, and I think he's confident enough and tanky enough to not use the BKB unless he absolutely needs to.
Yeah, and soon, once he has his MKB, which is only about 1350 gold short of, he's gonna hit hard. And that's gonna be a problem.
Yeah.
At the moment, I don't think they have really anything to answer against the BKB anyway, so... The best they can do is a toss.
Well, that's an unfortunate Earthshaker. No, he's gonna be okay. No engaged for no one. Could be going though, Seam of the Slayer as well as no one.
Glimpse into break of the Dream Call, punch into the air, and he just gets blown up here.
Yeah, no one recovering nicely from his earlier mid. He died a few times there, I think, if I'm not mistaken, to combine efforts of Hook as well as a Urshaker rotation here and there. So he's gotten really nicely back into the game. Actually, almost second in farm, only, you know, tiny. Yeah, exactly.
it's not that close, but yeah, he is getting up there. Yeah. He has some farm. Mm. He has his ult. He essentially has what he needs, so everything after this is just, you know, nice.
Yeah. And we'll have to see if he goes for a Dagon build. Could be going for Shiva's or Scythe, or a Shiva's or a Scythe build as well, depending on what they need. I think a Shiva's build would be really nice.
Yeah, they have so many melee heroes, and just guiding them makes it becomes easier then. So yeah, I would like to Shiva's as well.
The chat might disagree, but you know.
There are always people disagreeing with you.
Yeah, that's a good thing about a caster. You can always second guess him.
That's a good thing about being a player, though. You can always, you know, do something else and just annoy the casters.
Yeah, you can just yeah. Sure, Toby. I'm not gonna get BKB this game.
Yeah,
it's
they have so much magic damage, but no.
No, I'm
no.
Not. Damn it, no.
Just send a tweet while he's casting, dude. No BKB today.
Yeah.
I don't care if I win.
Yeah, I just because you said.
I'm not gonna get it.
I'm gonna get a BKB. I'm not gonna get a BKB.
There'll be a
but
new
talk
wave
about
game.
BKBs. We got an MKB on the gyro.
He finishes it up. Yeah. Okay. He's happy.
Aegis ran out, but he has. I think that's a decent item trade. MKB for a.
For an Aegis. Yeah.
For an Aegis.
I would take the trade.
Yeah, it's a good trade.
The earlier you get it, the better it is.
Looking scary for the side of here. Mind control. Get a TP out just in time.
And I really need to back up there. We're just clearing the Asian stack. They were a little bit low on HP, so they can't really fight. So.
Yes.
Do Vega just want to push out? They just want to push out the towers, the creep waves for now. I think they will just wait for the next rush.
Yeah, I think they're just gonna be cooped up here, you know, with Vega being pretty much. Oh, it's gonna be a sentry. Hook's gonna spot it, I think. I hope at least. Yeah, he should be.
There's a lot of
they
things.
Know. Yeah, they. Actually, an Invis rune, so it's not a Vendetta used. So he can disengage. To some extent. They do have detection. He's gonna be pretty sad, so. Here we go. Hook.
Do they have a gem or something?
They have a sentry on Tusk, I just saw that, but I don't think they have a gem yet. No.
A gem. Just a sentry, yeah. It's some detection, but yeah, just one is not enough.
No.
And he will see that now.
Out. Yeah.
There's gonna be the stun, Vendetta, Dagon! Oh, he's still alive!
Enough. Yeah, he's
gonna go somewhere. He's still gonna go down, though. But there we go. Oh, what? Still alive? Yeah. There we go. Look, what? Mind control. That's
wow.
Okay. Well.
Okay.
If you want somebody dead.
Top lane and Hook.
Oh, glimpse back into kinetic storm static field, and he's dead. Oh, Carapace. He's alive a little bit longer. There's gonna be illusion rope. Warning rift. He is dead right now.
There we go. There's a bit of delay on the stream, so you should be.
You should be seeing that in about, 1 second or so.
Yeah, he's dead.
Yeah, did you see the sigil flying around?
Yeah.
I like it with F.
Yeah. Oh, control gonna TPR should be okay. Pasha doesn't. Fine. Yeah, there we go.
With VG on it.
Yeah.
A little bit of advertising for that team here.
Yes.
I wish he played in this tournament.
Can
it be great?
Wow. Yeah. Wow. If you had that, if you had them in the tournament, that would have.
It would have just been amazing.
Yeah. Gonna be a. Puck picking up the no one's gonna be picking up the Aghanim Scepter.
Nice.
So it's a good item.
Yeah, with all the they should start building BKBs. Yeah, they have one already on the Kun. He's going for gold now. I think he's the only one. Yeah.
Yeah, I think Windranger's just gonna get one after she gets her Aghanims.
No, I usually first go first gonna go Chrysalis. And Pepe, he goes in with an Echo, but he doesn't kill off anybody. There's already Glimmer guy came out of the Parsha, so he's taking almost no damage. And now, BKB out from the Kun. Yeah, they're not gonna be able to keep him here.
Yeah. And you remember the gyro we talked about at the early stages of the game? They didn't contest his farm, he was going to be a problem.
Yeah, now he's a problem.
He's a problem now. He's a really big problem. So we'll have to see if they can, they have an answer for it. They're going to be doing a bit of split pushing here, as they know with Earthshaker down and he used his Echo in that fight, there's nothing they can do to stop this push at the bottom lane.
Yeah, but hey, they're trying to answer correctly here, but no one. He's just gonna get the Dream Core out. Oh, Vacuum into the wall. Pretty nice here. But they're still so far all alive. No one taking big damage here, but Hook, he's gonna take the spill here due to the fact of the Flak Cannon. Just blowing him up. As a 2-for-0 trade. They tried to split up the map, but Vega was a little bit too fast on trigger to stop that.
Yeah. And well, 21-23. Vega looking to get ahead in kills and ahead in farm. They're roughly 5 to 6k ahead net worth right now, even before that exchange. So, looking really good for the side of Vega. Pasha just farming up like a madman. Has actually, what is that? That is 6k actually ahead of the Tiny, and Puck being the second on the team, looking at 12k. So he's really racking up the net worth. He's wow.
Yeah, he has actually 306 less hits right now. And with his creep wave, is gonna be over 315 almost now. He's just farming like a madman, yeah.
I think he's probably gonna go going for a Satanic. I'm not sure why he went for the Sanj and Yasha.
Is this something that they tend to pick up more often right now, just to give a little bit more survivability and speed? And you can always just use it to build something else later, or just use the Yasha to build a Manta.
Or something like that, yeah.
It's just a transition item.
With his farm being as it is, and with the gold he currently has, I think he could have bought the, or I know he could have bought the Satanic and still be okay. I guess it's a kind of way to secure the, you know, mid game and just have an inventory or an item in your inventory to get that space filled out so you don't lose out on stats. But yeah, it's still kind of curious to me because we saw that with the Sven as well, where he bought Mask of Madness and then went for BKB and then Sanj and Yasha, and then he sold the mask, and you know, it was, you know, he kept selling and buying items. It was, you know, from a casting point of view, it's kind of okay.
So yeah, a little bit off. You're gonna lose money somewhere in the process.
Exactly. And well, it's gonna be a pause coming up for the side of a Vega. I think they lost Vanscore.
Yeah, that's so far the story of the match.
Of the game.
Yeah. if there's a pause on the side of Vega, the Vanscore. I will probably get. I'm gonna ask him what's up.
Yeah. Question mark?
The universal way to ask what's up.
Yeah, what's.
What's going on?
Heart issues.
Heart issues, okay. Yeah. Well, we'll give him a second then, or. 1 sec, okay, well. Go then. But yeah, okay, we'll wait this one out a little bit more.
Yes, so with this Rosh, do you think Vega's gonna go for that?
End push, yeah, definitely.
End push, yeah.
There's no reason to really drag it on. The longer you drag it, the more chance essentially Hei has to get back into the game, because the later stage is just you lose one fight and you lost the game. At this point, if you lose one fight, you're still able to get back.
And this is the best of three. I just want to remind people that
in the Mountain Thrill Challenge, loser bracket round number 2 here. And we're gonna start again. I just was gonna do like all the sponsors and stuff, but I'm still gonna do it. We have Intel.
Okay.
We have Intel. We have HyperX. We have eBattle helping us out as well. We have Dota HQ. And yeah, that was about it, I believe.
So. That's about it, okay. I thought you were gonna just keep saying sponsor name.
I'm pretty sure I missed one though.
Yeah.
Asus, yes, we have Asus, Republic of Gamers as well. Okay. Shout out to them as well. Back into the game. And they got Rush.
They got Roche, Aegis on Gyro, and probably going to be looking to close out the game with that. It kind of feels Tiny's underwhelming in the fact that he doesn't have his Wisp with him. You know, it's kind of just a standard, you know, each game you see a Tiny, you almost always see a Wisp.
Yeah, and this is kind of the reason, like, now he's just, he needs to pick up a Blink Dagger.
Oh, my
be
control.
Mobile, so, oh yeah, he's going to die here. They even popped a BKB on Pasha here to kill him off. That might have been a little bit of an overcommitment, but still
yeah, I guess that he doesn't care right now, at least with the Aegis. He's gonna be like, well, just go and end, you know. There are a lot. Like he just picked up a, picked up that. It was the. I think it was the. Yeah, it was the gyro. Gamba butterfly.
Oh, that's a whiffed Dreamcore there from that one.
Oh, there's a Ricky right here. Can you see him?
Yeah, I can see him. I can see him there really clearly. He's gonna. Oh, we actually have fights on two sides. Bastion's gonna get initiated on by Hook. And he's gonna take the spill here. There we go. This is gonna be the Aegis down. It's meantime. No one also dies. Clears back on Hook. He's into a static storm here. He's taking a lot of damage. He's gonna take the fall. Pasha is again locked into the tree for a nice cuddle. Snowball of Tusk is gonna hit HWI. He's still outside of the base. He's gonna get punched up into the air. And he is stuck here right now. Fisher's just trying to buy a little bit more time, but although the another nice shackle there, it's not gonna be enough to save his life. Two down on the side of Heihei with no buybacks.
Yes.
So that's a problem.
That's the problem. You got a gyro in the mid doing a lot of wow.
Well, that Echo Slam was a little bit underwhelming, but the Laguna Blade on the other side wasn't. Pasha is gonna die here. They have to start running away right now. LSA still hits Mac. Mac is getting touched up into the air. He's gonna die as well. Petsko's able to run out. Oh no. Chima, he was found by Kwepe. We still have the signal there, slowing them down. When is the Fissure gonna be up? Well, they don't need the Fissure. There's the Avalanche and a nice old slap from the Coon to kill him off. You're gonna farm the Sigil as well? Nope.
Yeah, they got it. They got it. Okay. At the end, Lina was painstakingly slow at taking down that that Sigil. But in the end, she does pick it up, 120 gold. And look at that fight recap, man. Wow. Wow. A lot of gold going the way of Heihei United.
Oh, I forgot to click on it. Damn it.
Okay, I can tell you.
Tell me, man.
they got 3.8k. You know, in their favor, and then the side of Vega lost 1.4, actually 1.5k.
Okay, so that's about 4-5k ish.
Yeah. Nice. Let's just go with that, so we don't have to do maths on stream. That would be embarrassing. But yeah, 4-5k ish.
I have a calculator.
Really? Okay, yeah. But I just lost it. Okay.
Well, I'm not gonna calculate it, but you know, if we really want to go
if
try
really
hard,
need, if you need anything, you know.
Yeah, guys. If you need something calculated in the chat here, guys, I got a calculator here. Yeah. I can even do like the cos and the sinus and whatever. It's all on here. I haven't had it since high school, but I should be able to do it.
Yeah, I think so.
Hopefully.
Can you handle it? I can come over and we can, you know.
Yeah, I'm gonna fail at it, but it doesn't matter. So far, it's a little bit of a stalemate. Like, I think Vega did just
took
a spill.
I think Vega, like, okay, guys, game plan. We need to get another Roche. We need to farm the gyro a bit more. Probably get him a Satanic.
And well, they actually opted to get the butterfly. So
he had that in his stash, and he had the Aegis, and he was like, well, I'll just take the Aegis then. And,
honestly, I would just swap out the HUD for the butterfly then.
Yeah.
You know, say towards CMO, dude, get a Vladimir's. I want lifesteal. And just leave the HUD till after the Aegis.
Yeah.
There are already two Glimmer Caves, three Glimmer Caves up. Oh.
All in.
Yeah, he's gonna die. Oh, Glimmer Cave.
Oh, the Glimmer Cave.
What?
Used.
What, so many Glimmer Caves? He just runs out, he's gonna put the TP out. Okay.
Glimmer that Cave. Is a lot of resources spent on to just to support Lina, who actually in the end survives.
They should have checked if he had a Glimmer Cape or not.
Like, yeah, I think it's because they just lost the gem, so they're kind of curious to why didn't we just see her and kill her. But yeah, they don't have any detection up on Tusk or the Disruptor, I think. Where's the Disruptor? Here we go. Doesn't have any. They have Glimmer Caves. Hook in the mid lane.
Parsha is coming in with the BOTs, but the Hook. There's a nice Fissure keeping him out, but the Glimpse is even better. He does have Vendetta. Blinks out. Safe. However, Parsha, he tries to go in aggressively. He's gonna get a dig, and LSA, Laguna Blade, dead. The Coon, he's gonna try and get a little bit more work done here. However, Vega is trying to say no to that with a nice big combos here. Slap into the air. One dead, two dead. Double kill. Seema. Oh no, Hook is into the air right now. The Coon is still fighting. He's fighting up versus Seema, but he has no detection himself. He's gonna miss on the Avalanche. Hook is still up there. He doesn't want to walk through the wall here. HWO, he's going after Mac. He has his his running speed here. His running boots on. They're gonna keep on following him. He's gonna run even faster here. Surge? Nope. HWO, he's still pursuing this.
Yeah, wow, that was... He should have stayed with the team. I think he could have picked up the Tusk instead of going for the Darkseer. Because Darkseer is obviously one of the most evasive heroes in the game.
Yeah. He can just With the surge, yeah, if you don't have enough to keep him down.
Exactly.
Just give up. Yeah. Just help your team.
And he missed the initial shackle, so there was no way that Mag was going to get caught with, you know, with no help from, you know, Nyx was really low. Tiny was half HP and...
Nyx wasn't even close. He was stuck on the cliff.
Yeah, he was chilling up here, right? Like something around here.
Yeah. He was standing there, just, you know, enjoying the view.
Yeah, like, oh, there's a wall down there? I'm not going to go there.
Good luck, HWA.
Yeah.
But again, a big fight going the way of Hair.
Yes, actually, extremely so. Pasha not using his BKB in time. Yeah. And just getting dropped immediately. Yeah.
He just wants to get the kill. I just followed him in on good faith. Like, he's not going to stop and turn around to stun me. He doesn't dare. And then it was like, whoops.
Yeah. I think he wasn't expecting the Tiny to be there. Like, just an easy kill up on the, as you said, on the Nyx. But in the end, he just... melted. It was a good, I guess it was a bait in a sense, but because they were kind of waiting in the tree line there. So good job by striking back a bit, making the game actually dead even in terms of net worth as well as experience. Actually a bit in their favor if you look at
a little bit.
Experience gained. So always good, a balanced and an even game.
And the good thing that Hayes is it's a little bit more spread over their team. Like the supports also got some farm.
Yeah.
And that does help out with Glimmer Gates, Yules, and now even the starting up Neganims onto the Lina. Kwepe, yeah. What's Kwepe going? He got a cloak and an ultimate orb.
He's kind of scaling in both directions. He's not really sure.
I can get the cloak. It's just for the magical damage, I guess.
There's a lot of magical on the side of Vega. I guess the ultimate orb was for Scythe. It's a possibility.
Yeah, I would assume.
You can blink in Scythe the gyro immediately, and then, you know. But it's still a risky item. I don't know if it's the correct one, but we'll have to see what he goes. That's probably the most obvious item I can think of, because there's a lot of stuff you can get with the ultimate orb.
Yeah, it's just so many possibilities.
Could be a Lincoln for the Tiny, if we're just, you know.
Running things out there. It could also be a Skadi.
Could also be a Scotty. You would love to see a Scotty or a Shaker.
We never know, man.
No, we never know. It gives him a lot of sense. He's all over the place. He's like, guys, give me the farm. I'll show you how to win a fucking game, okay? I'm just going to farm a Scotty, okay?
Yeah, it would be funny. I wouldn't really like it. He just following around.
Strength does scale well with the Ear Shaker. So I've actually played a few games in my 3.9.
Dude, you just want to keep on saying that.
Yeah, I just keep on saying it, you know, where I played
as a 3.9 player.
Fucking works. good hero. Good shit. Oh, just Mac and Chan showed him and get like drums, urn, and power threat. You just
Chrysalis!
Yeah, exactly. You just go in and hit people in the face with your totem. It's really good fun. Even if you lose, it's still like one shotting a Crystal Maiden or Revenge. It's just like, haha.
I have fun.
Yeah, I don't care. I lost. I just killed you instantly. It's fine. And now that's a big pickup for Vega.
Ooh, the Aghanims onto the Disruptor. That's the AoE Doom coming into effect here. Well, no one up from the side of Heihei, apart from the Kun on the Tiny, who has a BKB, is actually able to deal with that. And even then, if the Kun gets caught into it,
it's devastating.
He's gonna die. I say die a lot, but hopefully he dies then. Instead of a drawn out 5 for 10 seconds, I'm like, no. Yeah.
No.
This is a little bit of a delay.
Satanic on gyro.
Got it?
Yeah, he did. He doesn't have buyback for it, or for the if he dies now.
Yeah, he doesn't have buyback.
So,
but he is 6 slotted.
Yeah, he is 6 slotted, so should be okay for the fight.
It's not all T4, but
he could sell the SNY.
Yeah.
He
could build anything you want essentially into it.
Yeah.
If you still want like the stats and the slow, go Scotty. I'm gonna assume he might want to go a little bit more damage oriented and get a divine.
Yeah, probably. I hope so. Please, let it be a divine.
If he wants to chicken out a little bit, he's gonna get a probably Chrysalis into Daedalus along those lines.
Yeah.
That would be another option. I don't think Manta.
I think Manta would be the same kind of, you know, as Sanjinasha. So.
And with an Earthshaker there, it's not really what you want.
No. Well, here we go. They're gonna scout out Vega as they do see them at the river bend. Roche, the third time the charm, as Cheese is gonna get dropped this time around.
I'm just wondering, what is Parshad gonna drop here?
I don't think he's gonna drop anything. I think he's gonna give
Yeah, Sanjay, yeah,
he's actually gonna. Okay, no.
So there's a 4.2k item on the ground here. And yeah, he's like, they picked it up, Just stalling here, throwing out some shards. Revolutionary
Orb. Mag's gonna pick up the. Or no one's gonna pick up the cheese, and then Pasha's gonna take the Aegis, right?
No, man. They're gonna deny both.
Let's see. Here we go.
No, no one is actually throwing out the Illusionary Orb. He's gonna
get it. That was a bit premature, but yeah, in the end, he does pick up the cheese and.
Yeah, your predictions were right.
My predictions are always wrong.
Wrong.
Each time
wrong.
I say a team is gonna win, they just lose.
You better. You said this match is gonna be hey, so far. It might actually. Well, Vegas is
going to.
Oh, he can be used, but no one. Malkador, he just goes in fist. Now they're gonna find Pasha. He's fighting up versus the Coon. He still has the Aegis. Wall into a nice vacuum here. And they just start TPing out. They're done. They don't want to keep on fighting.
Yeah. They really need detection on the side of Vega. I can't stress that enough. Lina and, you know, they just keep running out with their glimmer. Gas capes. Yeah. Oh my, they just. It's like, oh, bye-bye, it's fine.
You remember those 4 or 5 days that the Glimmer Cave was no mana?
Yeah, that was stupid. And it had, what, 66% magic resistance?
Well, still, 50 is still a lot as well.
Yeah.
Or 60, I don't know what exact number.
Yeah. It was...
It was 66 into 50, right? Or 55, damn it.
I think it was 55 or something.
Yeah,
like
55, I just checked it. I wasn't completely sure.
It was reduced bottom lane.
No one, he didn't get Shackle there. But there is going to be a static storm and kinetic field onto HWA, and he's going to take a fall. Now they have two men down, they do have buybacks on them. Who goes in? But so far he's kind of alone. Who comes in now as well with a nice blink avalanche toss onto no one? Barsha's still in the front line. He's just tanking this up with the lows open him as well. Mighty Pull, yeah, he's going to die here. They do have a gem. They're going to pick up this gem as well. Now they have two gems on Fanscore. He has some blink blink on him. Hook, he goes in. Fissure, there, no, yeah, Fissure's there as well. Touch Snowball, Coon, BKB thrown up into the air. He gets a nice slip onto Seema, but it doesn't really matter that much. They don't really have detection for Pasha right now. He just uses his satanic and goes into him. Does it to the air. He's still alive. Mind control, he's gonna use himself up. Pasha is all alone, but he still has the Aegis. His team has time to come back to him in the second time around, but I say that, but they're already all in their base. He's just gonna die as well.
Yeah, he's gonna take a drop here. This is looking kind of scary for Vega, though. That was... I mean, you know, they killed off the Windranger. There was two buybacks used on the side of Hehe. But, you know, using your Disruptor ulti on a solo Windranger...
Yeah,
not enough. You know, it's they get the kill, but it's not
enough. If he didn't have buyback, it was enough.
It would have been worth it. But the fact that they just waited it out, they took the Tau, and then immediately buyback from Lina as well as Windranger... In the end, it's looking scary for Vega. They've had Roche 3 times in a row now, and have yet to take a set of racks or just even a rack. They've taken a tier 3 tower.
Well, at least it's more than it was before.
Yeah, it was. That is true. They lost the fight kind of here and just died.
Yeah.
And look at the Tiny as well with that. Actually, only 2k or 2 point. Yeah, actually 2k in.
Below, yeah.
Below the Tiny or the.
Mid lane. This is own news. Avalanche, he is using his BKB right now to get out with his Illusionary Orb.
Wow.
He does get a nice crit in his face though. They want to force the buyback here on Pasha. There's going to be the AoE Doom casted, but it's just going to hit Mind Control well as the Coon in the tail end. Now they're going to go for the tower.
Okay, here we go.
And what? Okay, there was a mistake there.
No, it's a misplaced
HWA, he was a little bit trigger happy, I guess.
Yeah. Well, Gyro's still... 16 seconds away, 14, 13. It's gonna be a bit of a.
Ooh. He goes four with the snowball. Where the hell the Coon went? He glimps back all the way back into the base. Mikator has another. Glimmer Cave there. Well, the BKB out is there from the Coon. Mikator is fighting it up here, and so far he is still alive, but that will end fairly soon. Search after him, and there you go.
Yeah.
Some ice shards to kill him off. No buyback on him though. 16 seconds down for the count.
Wow, and they really want to end the game.
Yeah, they want to end it now. They know that he's down and just want to go.
Yeah. Gotta remember though, Tiny still has a buyback.
Well, actually, has buyback.
Ready if you want it. And I guess what does he get now? He sells the blink and gets a.
He just sold something. He lost 3k gold. Where the hell did he put?
Yeah.
He already had his items. Maybe.
They need.
Daedalus?
He's got. I don't know. He had the Daedalus. Oh, he sold. Oh, he just bought a moon shard. Holy shit.
Oh, he. Oh, yeah, shit.
Shit, he just.
He just
used. Didn't see that at all. He's had a moon shard effect on him for a few minutes here. That's why he's.
Nah, not for a few minutes. He just.
No, but you know, he just bought it. But yeah. Wow.
Well, okay. I wanted to see that.
Yeah, I haven't seen that in a professional game that I've casted yet.
Or that I've watched it, right? Oh, there's gonna be the homing missile! Is he gonna... Yeah, he's just gonna let it explode into the carapace.
Yeah. Top lane. Be pressured.
Oh, as... HWA, he is still... So far, he's fine, the game's back! This is not good enough! This is pretty much a whiff static storm, but HWA will still die. Do it, there comes the Kun, he goes in! Barsha, there's gonna be the dunk as well, they're all stuck together, there's gonna be some knife cleaves here going the way of Kun. There you go, one dead, two dead, they get one Rex, they're gonna go pursue this, Hook, he kills up one as well, no one. Ooh, glimpse back here, but Kun is still there, no one. Oh, look at these double crits here, while Kwefe also gets a kill, 5-man wipe.
Jesus Christ, the Kun, man, having a blast with his, oh my god, the cleave is real. He was almost cleaning up everybody, like, in that initial, you know, strike with his giant club, Jesus.
I mean, he also really, really has RNG going for him with the crit.
Yeah, he wow.
2 times in a row, just dead. 1,000 crit hits. It's over. Whoa.
Well, that was insane, and that might just be, it's definitely mid-Rax going in the favor of, hey, let's see, they do have a buyback on the Gyro, the Darkseer, and the Tusk. But it's not going to be enough, and I think the puck buyback was a big.
They're going to lose stop as well.
Yeah, and with the tiny.
Or they're going to just.
They're going to go for the end. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, that's the best play.
Buybacks. Here we go.
That's just going to
be
there.
Enough, though.
They need to start buybacking right now.
Yeah, they need to do it now.
Yeah, like they're going to be too late. There we go. They're going to do it now. They just waited for Tusk.
They're
going to
be fine. They're like fine.
They're just going to be in the backline here. There's going to be the TP in towards the back of Pash. He's fighting up versus Scrappy, but the Kun is there. He's trying to slap into him, but he doesn't have an MKB. But he does miss. Fairly often. He's fairly low, still alive though! The Kun Blade on Barsha, he uses his satanic to keep himself alive and the Kun is not able to do anything versus this. Two men down, they do have buybacks though. And Tusk also bought back now.
Yeah, but they got buybacks on both the Tiny as well as Nyx. I'm pretty sure they're pretty content with that. I think he needs to sell his Blink Dagger and get an MKB.
Yeah, he still wants. It's really hard as a tiny with no eye. Like you kind of want the mobility.
You kind of want
mobility. You need to slot for something else.
But I think they want to get some force staffs on the side of Hehe and kind of just get him around. It's gonna be a scythe coming up for Urshaker as we talked about with the ultimate. Oh, he's gonna take a drop maybe here on the bottom lane. QP. Yeah.
But that's some next level. I want to say call down there, but
yeah.
I think he expected him to walk back, but
yeah.
Prepare is too manly to do that.
That's a good shackle on a bad score.
But no follow-up, just... Oh, what? Snowball in? He's going pretty far to HWA. There's going to be the static storm onto just the mind control here. He doesn't have to buy back. And they're going to lose a Tusk for this so far. Ooh. Blink back! Oh, Echo Slam there as well. They're all stuck together. All the ultimates are thrown out right now. The Kun is trying to slap this one. They're going to throw back pressure, trying to create a little bit more distance here. Barsha now is man fighting and he gets another Dagon into the face. Kun, oh, he just keeps on walking through the wall, giving illusions there to Mac. Blink forward from no one. He's gone. Oh, he's still alive. He was able to illusionary orb out. Mac picks up the kill here with the Iron Shell. This might just be end.
Yes, this might just be game. That the lack of MKB, I think, is the big issue here. Even though, as you said, the Blink was probably necessary for him. I think he needed to swap it out at the end because Gyro was... He was dodging...
So many hits.
Yeah, and... Well, Pasha? Gonna be shackled up here, but it's gonna be of no consequence, no one. It's
well,
no, chasing down.
Well, they're gonna be consequences, but that's on the side of Hey.
Exactly.
They're gonna lose everybody.
Yeah.
There's a buyback on Quepe, and he just instantly uses it. He still has the Thunder on top of it.
Oh, wow.
I didn't know that could actually happen. Okay. Oh, you learn something new every day. He's looking for something. He's looking for an echo. 40
he doesn't
seconds.
Have the echo though.
Yeah, 40 seconds.
Yeah. It's gonna be a long echo.
He has an enchant totem. He's all charged up.
Yeah, he's got it ready. He's got Scythe in 5 seconds. If this is the time to go.
Mind control, he starts walking in with a glimmer cape. They see fan score and oh, the mecha just in time. Dreamcall is now used on mind control. There's gonna be the call down. And Maikito, he's just walking around with it on him, but yeah, he will take a spill. But not without at least taking the disruptor with him. And this is gonna be GG called by the Coon.
Wow, that was a
really close game.
Play from Vega, even without Solo in the frame. Wow. I'm just baffled. It was such a close game.
Like, this is not what people were expecting from here.
No.
This game was really close.
Whoa. Wow. Wow. Yeah, I'm still shaking a bit here because this was a good game. Wow.
Good to see. Yes.
They're really evenly matched, like. With like 80 to 20 odds?
Yeah, that is.
Yeah. Expected, but.
Some nail biting end there at the. Wow. Wow. I'm still kind of sad that we didn't get to see Tony with a MKP.
Yeah, this well, this was guys. It was ladies.
We're just wowing. We're just wooing Whoa. And wowing at, yeah, the, this at is, the sheer amazement of this game.
Yeah, okay, guys, this was the first match. Best of three. It's taken by the Faker Squad, and we're gonna go over to the break. Put us on commercials. Make the sponsors happy, and we'll see you guys soon again.
Yes,
with some more wowie.
Some more wowie. Yes.